if you've got this problem, a very slow emptying bath. It's still going out, but it's very, very slow. And I'm going to show you how to fix it without a plunger or chemicals. When you're fixing your bath, if you've got access through your panel, which this one does, if you get access under your bath, then this is the best way to fix that slow emptying bath. If you don't have access, then you're reduced to using either a plunger or some chemicals put down. But this has been getting slower and slower, and now I'm going to investigate why it's getting slower. So, the first thing to do is remove your bath panel. So you want to remove it. This one is just held by a little bit of silicone. It should just be. That's great. So the part we want to get to is this U-bend here. You can see it here. This is a bit that attaches to the bath, a U-shape, and then it attaches onto the waste pipe. This might be why it's a slow empty, because this bath has an elbow and then another elbow and then another elbow before it goes out. Three elbows. So that's going to slow down the flow. So the first thing to do, make sure there's no water in your bath. And I'm just going to undo that. And then we're just going to pop that off. Already, you can see that there's a massive amount of stuff in there. So I've popped that off the bath. Now, I'm just going to undo this one. Next is, and that's it, slowly. Now this is full of water. There we go, look at that. That is what's slowing down. So I don't know if you can see that. It's at both ends there, look, all the way around the U-bend and into the pipe. That'll be why it's going slow. Just try for the floor here. I'm going to pull this out, just to make everybody sick. And it goes, that's connected all the way through. That is what's in there. And that's why it's good to clear your pipes this way rather than force that through with a plunger, because that could actually block further down the pipe. Especially with these extra bends that are in this pipe. Then that would, you know, it would just block further down somewhere and make it even more difficult to find where this had went. So if you've got access under your bath, this is what you want to do. That is just a matted pile of hair. Disgusting. Right, so I'm going to pour this in the sink. Don't pour it into your bath. When you're emptying this, don't pour it in your bath, remember, because you don't have a drain anymore. Now there's a wee another clump in there. I don't know if you can see that, it's not very bright. But there's some more. It's absolutely minging. And that's it clear. And that's the pipe. There's nothing in that pipe either. So what I'm gonna do, stick this back on. Now you can see in there there's a wee rubber. See that? There's a rubber there. Now you've got to make sure that's located on nice and flat onto your bath waste, otherwise you will it will leak. These are quite difficult to get back on without leaking, so you just take your time, screw it up on the right thread, and it'll be fine. So, first thing to end off here, what I'm going to do is I'll take that off. So you've got these bits, you've got the bit that you screw on, you've got like a plastic washer, and then you've got the rubber. So the washer goes on first, then the rubber, and I want to put that on the pipe, just there. So I'm going to turn that up so you can see it, and I just put that on there like that. And then I'm going to bring it down. Now usually you won't have a lot of movement, this one's got a wee bit of movement. I can put that on. Now, the important bit to get on is the bit under your bath. Again, you want it nice and flat. So that's it, you'll know straight away if you've got it on the right thread. It'll be nice and easy to turn. I don't know if you can see any better. Right. That up to that like that, and then we get this one on. Just make sure they're straight. And that on. Nice and tight. Just make sure they're all tight. All these fittings. So at least I've got this. Just so many of them. It's all tight. Sometimes messing about, you can loosen them off, so any you can reach, make sure they're just tight. Hand tight's fine. Right, I'm going to fill up the bath. You want to just put a small amount of water in your bath and then just pull the plug. And what you're looking for is any drips, any dripping anywhere. If anything is oozing out or leaking, I can hear that already much faster. All looks good, nice and dry. And sometimes what you do is dry this off. Dry off the fitting so that if it gets wet again, you know you've got a wee leak. Sometimes the leaks are really small. Okay, so I filled up the bath a wee bit. I'm just pulling the plug out now. This is a good test, you can hear it running away. So if you have a look under, looking for any leaks, any drops, it all looks good. It's all sealed up now. There's a wet patch under there, but that's from where I took it off. There's no additional dripping. And that's good to go. That's it. Put the bath panel back on and that's you. Done. That'll flow for years again. So you can see, it's really sucking that water out now. Sucking plenty. Okay, good. And that's us.